once near the islands, lonely Gulf Islands, dark as the night, with the fog rising fast. There, near the islands, the lonely Gulf Islands, two weary fishermen in active paths. And this is what happened, a strange thing that happened to two weary fishermen in active paths.
Hit it, roll for the shore. Whoa, Barry! interesting.
You kidding? We gotta be off of here once this fog lifts. No way.
Oh, it's the fog. You wouldn't be here at all if it weren't for that.
Yeah, sure. Say, is there anywhere around here we get a little breakfast?
Mm-hmm. I guess so. Follow me, eh?
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. I guess we better play along.
Well, listen. This place was on the chart I found, but it wasn't on that other one.
The one that you burnt, you mean? So what are you trying to tell me, Carl?
I don't know. Hey, let's not lose this guy.
No, you're no kidding.
Indeed. Yes,
I'm a bit out of practice, but a final trip.
Well, perhaps Must be, he's a man and alive. I mean, hi. Listen, I'm sorry to appear rude, but with my sister's wedding, I have so much to do.
That was some great breakfast. Yep, that was awesome. Thanks. Ina. Well, I feel like a million bucks right now. After a few Z's, I'll feel even better.
Oh, there's a spare bed at my place, and I'm finished now until lunchtime, and I could quite easily fix you up.
Sure. Hey, what do you say? Get away from the hubbub for a while?
Hey, wait just a minute now. We got to try for some kind of answers before this fair gets too busy.
Well, I know who could help you. Roz, do you have a second?
Sure, Ina, and I'm not sure I caught your name.
Oh, Art Brannon, New York City. First time in British Columbia.
Carl Dennis, Brooklyn, same thing.
At least you could make it, and on the third date of our blessing, no less.
That's one of the things we were kind of hoping to hear about, was this blessing? Ina mentioned it and then wished she hadn't. The grocery man ran away when it looked like we were going to get curious. What exactly is going on here, anyway?
Yeah, like this morning, we were in this pea soup. Then all of a sudden, boing, hello, there you are. It's weird.
Oh, it's not so very odd. Well, we don't think so anyway.
And then we get change for our meal, and it's in all this pre-World War II coinage.
Yeah, like, what's with the 1945 welcoming home banner? Is the lieutenant back from Bosnia or what?
Look, there is an explanation, and I think you should have it. But I'm not the one. It's Pat Quayle, our island trustee. And she's in an important meeting with Mr. Matt Flow this morning. But I promise you, she'll see you and answer any questions you want to ask. Okay?
Ice cream!
Yeah. Here we go again.
No, we do not go again, as you put it. Miss Smith, Ross has promised we'll get to understand what's happening.
Hey, take it easy. Don't get put off by Carl. He's been a joker from way back.
Sorry. It's just kind of hard.
That's all right. I guess we'll get to understand sometime. Anyway, is there a phone we could use?
Yeah, there's one up at my place, but even my friends get to use it.
Ina, it can only make one call. Sorry.
Oh, that's all right. It's probably not going to matter that much anyway.
Hey, take a gander at this.
Well, Gable, you've done it now. No backsliding.
Listen, you girls, I love Maggie, and I have for a long time now. I'm going to make her a good husband if I can.
Sure, and we're going to help, right, Nina?
You can count on us.
Oh, listen, you.
You'll do the listening from here on in.
Yes, sir, with all those billing and points and stuff.
We do not bill and queue and stuff. Well, not much anyways. I used to have a roving eye, a good-looking girl, and I'd make a try. But she would get a frown if she'd try and tie me down. And then one day the hummingbird, this girl I saw in her voice I heard. So now I'd much prefer to go home with Maggie dear.
Go home, go home, go home with Maggie dear.
Especially important after that long climb.
I mean, I know. No, I mean, that's the way come you're here.
Listen, you. I'm not sure if I like the insinuation in that remark.
I'm sorry. I just mean that's how come you're so attractive and dynamic and a bit of an adventurer yourself you are.
Well, I could tell you a story or two.
Why don't you? I'll just lay down, take a little bit of a rest. You tell me all about it.
Okay, well, maybe I will. At 16 years, I was wild and free. And Dad told me it was time to be. So I set out to become a wife and meet the real love of my life. His first name was Chris and his last was McGlow. Oh yes, he's the brother of someone we know. He had lots of charm and a certain kind of touch and a certain kind of eagerness that I like very much. So then, where romance often springs, I gave him my heart and a few other things. How long on that hill did we stay? I don't know. But when I awoke, the moon had gone and so had Chris McGlow. So I went home and I thought I'd die. My ma and pa sure to make another try. So I'm still looking to be a wife and meet the real love. Came from the mainland, said he. I saw him and knew he was perfect for me. Just one thing was odd as we strolled to and fro, was he told me he had heard of me from his pal Chris McGlow. So then in the morn when the moon often springs, I gave him my heart and a few other things. How long on that hill did I stay? I don't know. But when I awoke, he'd gone, and that there I was alone. So I went home, and I told my dad. He said, what difference you got your youth? I told him straight, next one gets the knife, and met the real love of my life. This next was a soldier, a fine Scottish boy. He showed me the scars, and he called me his joy. I told him no chance, and he said that's okay. But somehow we got tangled in the barn and in the hay. My ma and pa said there must be one, a man who's true or too old to run. So I'm still looking to be a wife and find the real love.
Any of those things.
Well,
but I'll be there.
Don't fret, Magna, dear. As soon as you're safely wed, he'll get to accept it. You'll see. There's more than one girl in this island wants to look after him.
Well, Martin, I hope so. I really do.
Well, it's just a matter of time.
Thank goodness that's finished for another year.
Well, you did a great job, Ron, as usual.
Thanks, Pat.
Ron, now that the fair is over, we really need to talk.
Yes, we do, Pat. It's these two Americans.
No, but we're the visitors. Well, no, it's McBlow I wanted to talk to you about. He's formed a crazy scheme for logging the bulk of the eastern side with coaling. About half the island, it seems.
What?
Yes, and he's planning a dawn-to-dusk log raft trip to the mill on Salt Spring. Of course, he promises not to risk doing it himself, but he's hired a big team to do the job for him.
My God, what a horror!
I know. The trust is against it, of course. Just to think of all those scars on our hillsides and the mess of stumps left for the rest of us to look at for years. Oh, he says he'll listen to our recommendations and take them into account. Of course, but it probably won't change his mind.
For heaven's sake, he doesn't need the money. This is ridiculous. Well, at least he won't be able to get started today, what with the wedding and all.
No, he says tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
I know, he's already hired every jack on the island, and they're all busy sharpening their saws and getting ready to go. Really, it's too fantastic.
Well, I realize he hadn't been in good health for some time, but I didn't realize he'd lost his mind as well.
Exactly. Oh, God. Better get on to some of our other leading citizens, I suppose. Perhaps we could have a quick recap at the wedding reception tonight.
Good idea. See you later.
Okay, you get some rest.
Thanks. Now. Bye-bye.
Well, I am surprised. I didn't expect a regular New York guy to be such a good rider.
Oh, sure, not too much opportunity, but my fiancé has a place up on Long Island with a few ponies.
Yep. So, when's the magic day?
Oh, sometime. Not fixed yet. Still a few problems, you know. Boy, this view is really spectacular.
Yes, isn't it? No hurry, then.
What? Oh, Jane, no siree, no. I mean, there's no rush, really, no.
I think I understand. It seems okay, but you just feel there should be more to it.
Yes, that's it, exactly. We get on all right, but I don't know. It seems like it would be just more of a satisfactory arrangement than a love match. Boy, this place, this view is really something, you know.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
There's something odd about this island. From out the fog and strangely still, a sort of time has passed us by, lad.
Every pepper on the hill.
Just somehow here I'm more contented. Of city stress I've had my fill. Here the air is gently scented with the heather on the hill.
He is a pleasant lad, but he won't stay. It's really rather sad, I feel this way.
This is ridiculous, take my advice. And yet, she's nice.
There's nothing odd about this island.
Maybe we should walk the horses for a while to dry them off.
Sure, that's a good idea. Here's a pleasant land, and Fanny won't stay. It's really bothersome, I feel this way.
This is ridiculous. Take my advice. And yet, she's nice.
There's something odd about this island. When get away, then it's a real.
If you would stay and make it on wood, with the heather on that hill.
Sounds good, eh? Well, depends upon your point of view. to it. Ina, just wait. He will. He will.
Yes, he will. He will indeed. Anyway, our first minister thought long and hard upon these problems, or the potential problems, as you might say, that might pose a radical and unwanted threat to our way of life. And as an old man, a devout man,
truly good man.
Yes, indeed, a good man, truly. And he decided that before his time might come, he would ask the Lord for a blessing on his island, on account, as it were. A blessing on all his beloved parish. And so, public meetings were held. Anyone could voice their opinion, and some swore they'd leave if it happened, but most said they'd not. And so, our minister climbed Galadoon Mountain every night for weeks, and stood there at the top, praying to the Lord for a way, for a sign that we were not alone in this. And sure enough, the Lord spoke one night and blessed us.
That's it? That's the explanation?
Just wonder, what form did this blessing take exactly?
Ah, yes, the blessing, yeah. The blessing conformed exactly to our best expectations. Every night at 2 a.m., the island would vanish into the mists. And when at dawn it reappeared, 25 years and one day would have passed in the outside world. Long enough, the visitation suggested, for the island to avoid the worst effects of modernizing, civilizing, and other polluting effects.
You mean that yesterday here was October 13th, 1970? And that 2 days ago here was October 12th, 1945?
Exactly so.
No, wait. Let me see if I got this right. For the rest of us, it's October 14th, 1995. But here, it's October 14th, 1945?
I believe it is, yes.
My God.
No, indeed, our Lord. And now, I believe it's about time for the ceremony to commence.
Oh, right. We better get going.
But wait just a sec. If anybody wants to leave now, what happens?
Oh, that would unfortunately mean the end of it all.
Wait, you mean I gotta stay?
Yes.
Of course not. Only islanders or those who make a decision to become an islander.
Well, that's a blessing.
Ah, yes, a blessing indeed.
Well, come on, let's get out of here before he just keeps going on.
Well, thanks very much, Miss Dunner. I'm so glad I finally got to hear about it.
Ah, yes, got to hear about it at last. Perhaps later I got to decide about it.
Come on, Arthur. I have to change.
Oh, yeah, right.
Thank you. in what we hope will be a peaceful new era for our little world. By ancient island tradition, to vote for this unusual situation here today, we have come together for the wedding of Gable Harris and Margaret McBlow, and to rejoice with them. Is there anyone here who wishes to object to this union? If so, would they declare themselves? Good. Gable Harris, will you give yourself to Margaret to be her husband and to love, comfort, honour, protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both may live?
I do indeed so promise.
Margaret McBlow, will you give yourself to Gable to be his wife and to love, comfort, honour, protect her, him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both may live?
I do indeed so promise.
Do you, the members of the families of Gable and Margaret, give your blessing to this marriage?
We do.
You are the witnesses to these solemn vows now being made. Will you do all in your power to support and uphold this marriage?
We will.
Gable and Margaret have joined themselves to each other by the solemn vows signified by the joining of their hands. I declare them husband and wife. Right, lads, come on, kiss her. She's yours now.
Oh, you can do it. Enjoy your dancing, folks, because it's the last chance you'll ever have!
Oh, stop it! Oh, yeah.
Enough for both of us, for you to get any girl you care to. Now, come on, be sensible. What do you say?
Ha!
doctors. You can't tell anything up here.
Good idea.
Everybody settle down. Listen, we have to get away from the Scottish country dancing.
Oh,
why is this hour?
here.
No.
Call to Adi, call to Adi. The world's a long way away for these folks. Not for this cowboy. Nay, Victory, good buddy. Are you listening to me?
Yeah. Carl, you're absolutely right. But in a minute, okay?
Oh, God, red alert.
A little reminder of the past.
you all know, the McLowe family, well, Mike really, owns a great deal of our island. Now, Mike's not been feeling very well lately, and he wanted to leave something for the girls, Maggie and Fiona, a little nest egg. Something that wouldn't just be a big mess of forest management problems. Now, he decided that the best way to do this would be to log several sections of his property.
What?
Yes. And to put the money in an interest-bearing account for the girls to have after he's gone, as it were.
Well, this is his land, I guess.
Yeah, but who wants to live in a logging camp?
But think of the work for all those men.
Wait a minute. I agree this is definitely not the best time, but since Dad asked Pat to bring it up, I'd like to say I think it's a terrible idea. Not good for us. Maggie, Gable, and I, we should try and make our own way in the world, and certainly not good for our island. As someone just said, who wants to live in a logging camp? What we have here is something unique, a place of character, and with some real nice characters living here. Yeah. If there's not much happening here right now, well, we have enough intelligence to set things up and make them happen. Not just for us now, and for a few men looking to cut out the logs and move on, but for our children, maybe our children's children.
Yes, I absolutely agree with Fiona. Dad's plan would be a really wrong move.
I'm afraid I'd have to go along with that, too. I've seen a lot of messed up places in this world, and making things and making them work. Surely there's got to be a better way.
Look, folks, I'm just a visitor here, and an American at that, but from what I've seen here, and from the people I've spoken to today, I'm 100% certain that Fiona is right. You do have a chance here to build on creative skills, to develop fine things that the world can use and enjoy, not just hard manual work, but to select the right trees for particular uses, something you can build on, something that can last. Now, that sort of logging could bring steady employment for a very long time.
Yeah, well, we need steady work, you know?
The logging mills are going to be steady.
All right, listen. Mark has made a very good point here. There are many ways that we can look at any problem, and we must. But seriously, this is supposed to be a wedding. So, why don't we set a community meeting for tomorrow morning, say 10 o'clock? Everybody can come there and say.
Yeah, okay. We'll be there.
Europe, Asia. I just can't handle it, Fiona.
I understand. I really do. It was wrong of me to expect even for a moment that you might remember me.
Artie! Doctor!
I will.
Artie!
I really will.
Coming!
I was saying Audie was so far behind. Maybe we should plan on a different date.
See, Carl. Carl, I wonder, would you mind?
Yeah, sure. I could use a bit of a break, you know. It's just been so, so busy.
Now, look, Audie, we've been planning this on and off for months now. I know it's going to be a change for both of us. But recently, I'm getting to feel like some Cinderella at the ball.
All my hopes remain high and your thoughts drawn in fire. For you see,
and I believe we could get it for an especially low price. What do you say, Audie?
Yeah, I'm sure we probably could.
Well, I know it's not ideal, but why don't we make an offer? I mean, surely we don't want them to think we think that there's something odd about the place.
There's nothing odd about this island. And the winner is a wind. If you could stay and make it on,
I'm not sure I'm thinking clearly enough on this.
For heaven's sake, Arthur Brennan, ever since your return from that stupid mission trip, you've been absolutely impossible. I might as well go home.
No, Jane.
No? No what?
I mean, no, generally. honestly, I really am sorry, but it's just not gonna work. We can't get married. Not now. Not ever. Something did happen when I was away on that trip. It opened my eyes to a lot of things. Not just you.
Well, thank you very much.
No, I mean, it's not you. It's not your fault. It just wasn't meant to happen. And now it can't.
Well, if that's the last word on the matter, and it certainly sounds like it, I want you to remember that Daddy is a very smart lawyer. And a lot of money has gone into this firm.
And a lot of our friends think you've been really rotten to me.
Now go on now. It's so cold you breath. Wait to hear from me again.
Certainly thinks I'm nuts.
5 sort of misty nights and never a hint of anything. Still, this is really the first decent fog we've had. God. Watch myself here. One decent watch from a ferry, I could be swimming. The fact is, though, now that I've had some peace and time to think, I'm more certain than ever that Fiona is the girl for me. Jeez, if something doesn't happen soon, I could be over 60. For her to be just yesterday, for me to be a memory, history. No, can't happen. Fiona, Fiona, I love you. Come back, Fiona.
Well, I heard all this singing, and I felt